Hi, I'm Marco Beltrami. I'm a film composer, and I've scored numerous films, including Scream, A Quiet Place, Ford vs. Ferrari, and most recently, Fear Street. And this is called Scoreboard. Cue the music. See, what our first note here is top three scores of all time. You're giving me the hardest question first here. I can give you my favorite composers, Ennio Morricone, and I guess Once Upon a Time in the West would probably be one of my favorite scores, the way he mixed sound and music. Bernard Herrmann, let's say North by Northwest or Vertigo. Then Nino Rota, great with melody, his score 8.5. I mean, I danced to his waltz from that at my wedding, so. All right, scoring a slasher. In Fear Street, it felt like there needed to be an overarching theme. And the first place you hear this is in the very beginning, when the first girl gets killed in the mall. It plays throughout the movie, because the theme is their love story, which carries on throughout these three movies. And I think by having an emotional connection, it actually makes everything else stronger. In 1978, we thought maybe it'd be fun to play with the intervals between 1-9-7-8, starting out with the unison and then going to a major ninth above that, and then a major seventh, and then an octave above that. That became the theme that is used throughout for the mystery. The creepiest sounder instrument. All right, well, instruments such as the water phone, this like metal thing that you pour water in the middle and bow or hit these metal rods that come up, it gives it a really unique, creepy sound. And if you hit a bow backwards across a string, con legno tratto as they call it, your string player might not be happy with you because you're taking the enamel off their bow, but it gives a very creepy sound, especially when you have a whole string section doing it. Let's see what's next here. The first movie score that I remember loving. This would have to be Fantasia. The thing that sticks with anybody that watches that is the music, because the music is so prominent. I wouldn't say that got me into doing film scores, but it got me really excited about music, and I realized the power of visual images and music together. Let's see what's next. How Fear Street scores pay homage to horror. One thing that you might notice in these scores is that they all have a slightly different sound to them. Like in 94, it was very much influenced by Scream. And we had like huge orchestras and choirs. But we also were experimenting a lot with synthesizers. So there's a big electronic component to the scores as well. In 78, there's no synths at all. You know, it was almost like an excuse to revisit all the great horror movies of the 70s. There, the focus was more on the woodwinds and percussion, things that might clue you into being a little bit dated if you heard today. And then in 1666, that, ironically enough, is probably the most modern sounding because it didn't have to follow any of those conventions. It sort of could be its own thing. A score I wish I wrote. Well, Avatar, because there's so many different layers. There's the dramatic layer, there's the whole new world layer where you can create music that's completely new. There's a epicness to it, but there's also an intimate to it. I think that would have been a lot of fun to do. All right. The first thing I do when I start writing a score, watching the film if it's already been shot. I think the most deceiving and worst way to start is by working on a script, because you know you could just read it really wrong. I mean, when I was doing iRobot, I had 17 days from the time I first saw the movie. Luckily, the movie gave me so many ideas right away, so I knew exactly what I was gonna do. Sometimes it can be weeks. Then after it clicks, it's almost like putting pieces in a puzzle. Favorite piece of music I've composed. Shoot, favorite piece to, these favorite ones are really hard. All right, I'm gonna pick one. There's a cue from Hellboy called Fireproof. Hellboy is down with the subway. I remember having so much fun writing that piece of music.
waiting for me?
The orchestra nailed it. Runs the gamut from really small single instrument to full orchestra playing it. I think it's just an exciting piece. Most underrated film score. I don't know if they're underrated, but Japanese composer Toru Takemitsu did a score for an old movie called Woman of the Dunes. And it's this idea of sound and music working together. Because the whole movie is about this woman going crazy. She's constantly sweeping out her house, and the wind keeps coming and bringing the sand in. And just sonically, he defines her mental state. It's brilliant, you know, through sound exploration. To me, it was very influential. Director memories. Well, I was really a novice composer when I started with Wes, and the first movie I ever scored was Scream. Scream was a really low budget movie, and Wes took a huge chance with me, just making me see the picture in ways that I wouldn't have thought of and having the patience to let me learn. I remember with Guillermo del Toro, he was like right after Wes, my second movie was doing Mimic for him, and there would be a sound that we explored and it took a while to get, and then he'd be like, oh, this sound gives me the butt willies, he said. So every time, you know, we'd be working on another score, he'd say, give me the butt willy sound. So Lee, over the course of these movies, she's been such a proponent of the music. I mean, I think there's like 4.5 hours of music in the three movies together, which I collaborated with three composers, Marcus Trump, Brandon Roberts, and Anna Drubich. It's an homage to Wes, but it's also its own original thing, and she inspired me and Marcus and Brandon and Anna. I couldn't ask to work for a better director than Lee.
How do we not die? And I'm looking at you, witch nerd.
Check out Fear Street, now streaming on Netflix.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the Netflix Film Club channel to get our latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.